came from the four corners of the earth. Mightiest gladiators from Great Britain, Finland, America, and Russia. Together for the first time in history, united to accept the challenge of the international champion contenders in a battle that would decide who is the best in the world.
Along with English football great John Fashanu, I'm Mike Adamley. Glad you could join us for this very special international competition.
So let's meet our four contenders tonight who are going to battle it out. They are...
From Russia, Lena Girasimova.
And from the USA, Kim Tyler.
Lena, welcome. Where do you come from, your hometown?
I'm from Moscow, Russia.
And what do you do for a living?
I'm a student from medicine school.
Medical student. And how do you expect to do against the gladiators this evening?
I'm very expanded. I hope to win.
Great attitude to have. Lena Girasimova, best of luck to you.
Thank you.
Welcome. That was a very impressive opening. Are you a gymnast?
I have a little bit of gymnast background. From when I was younger, I used to do gymnastics way long time ago.
So tell us, what do you do for a living?
I'm an aerospace physiologist with the United States Air Force.
Whoa, ahoy! That sounds pretty complicated. Can you break that down a little bit slowly? What is that?
Well, basically what we do is I work with reconnaissance airplanes. They fly above altitudes of 63. And I work with astronaut suits. So our pilots need the suits that I work with in order to keep them alive. If not, they'll explode.
Wow, that's pretty complicated even in simple terms. So how do you think you're gonna do tonight?
Well, I'm gonna try and do my best. I'm gonna try and go out here and do 110% on each game that I compete in. So hopefully that'll be enough, but if not, then I'll have to give 500%.
Anybody here with you? Bring any supporters?
I sure did. My mother's over there, and of course, all my American contenders that are also going to be competing in the games.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Mom.
And a special little stuffed animal that I call Frank Jr. And Frank Sr. is my boyfriend back home, so Frank Jr.'s over there. It's a little bunny rabbit. That's like my good luck bunny.
Good. Kim, get yourself ready. Kim from the USA.
From Finland, Jarmo Jousisto.
And from Great Britain,
welcome. Where do you come from in Finland, your hometown?
My hometown is Lohja.
And what do you do for a living?
I'm marketing manager in a company named Sileka. And we sell heating cables and ceiling heating systems. You know, in Finland we have really cold winter time.
No kidding. But I understand your real passion in life is basketball. You're a shooting guard, an assist maker?
Yeah, that's my... You know, in games I must shoot 3 points, and also defense is one special to me.
Well, I know one of your fantasies is to one day play with Michael Jordan. Tonight, I hope you get to realize another fantasy, and that is to go up against the international gladiators. It should be something special. Good luck.
Thank you.
Jarmo Jousisto from Finland.
Well, Phil, tell us about yourself. What do you do for a living?
I'm teaching martial arts in Poole, Dorset. I'm one of the few authorized instructors in Jeet Kune Do and Kali.
And what do you do in your spare time? Anything else?
I've been involved in making a ladies' self-defense video, an instructional video, and that should be out now, right now.
So all you ladies out there should be very helpful for you. How do you think you're going to do tonight?
I'm looking forward to it. I'm not looking forward to Pyramid, but the rest of it should be fun.
Well, Phil, we'll see how you get in. Off you go, get yourself ready. Phil Norman from Great Britain!
Having said all that, let the games begin. We are ready for our first event. The women will go at it in the gauntlet. Ready for the run of her life, Russia's Lena Girasimova. Inside our gauntlet, our quintet of gladiators. They are Jazz, Falcon, Ice Ice Baby, Flash, and Zodiac. Over to our international referee, John Anderson.
Lena, our Moscow student, 5 foot 5 inches, 8 stone 7 pounds, a little underweight for this particular event.
Indeed, when she has to go against the likes of our five gladiators inside the gauntlet.
2, 1.
First up is Jazz, and a big shot straight away with that ramrod.
Ramrod from hell.
She's through, though, and the blocking pads of Falcon holding her up nicely.
If she can get through this gauntlet in less than 30 seconds, she's got 5 points.
Straight past Ice, though, but Ice is back on her feet again and doing a great job.
She's running out of time, however. 4 seconds, now 3, 2, 1, and that is it.
Great job by the girls, because Zodiac didn't even have to get her gloves out.
What's it like to be a human pinball? Well, Lena Girasimova just found out. She got bounced around big time. The gladiators went tilt.
Well, Lena, I'm sure you've been in many, many events, but that's got to be the hardest event you've ever been asked to run.
Они были очень
сильные. They were very strong.
Я понимаю, почему они гладиаторы.
Now I understand why they're gladiators.
Пройти,
it was easy to get through, but I tried.
Well, let's hear it for Lena from Russia.
Up next for our contenders from the United States, Kimberly Tyler. Over to the referee, John Anderson.
Kimberly, 5 foot 6 inches, 10 stone and 5 pounds. An aerospace physiologist from California. She'll need to go like a rocket today.
She certainly has that potential. She was a great track and field athlete at Ohio State University. Our American champion in 1993. Look at her go, John.
Straight through Jazz and Falcon into ice. Tremendous speed. She beats the Flash.
And Flash literally throwing Kimberly to the ground. Gladiator's not allowed to lean on the contenders using their body weight.
And indeed, Mike, the referee's asked her to carry on straight through, and she does, past the Zodiac.
Gets through in 21 seconds. Give Kimberly Tyler 5 points.
Congratulations, Kim. That was a tough one. You played it back home. You knew what to expect.
Yes, very much so. It was tough, but it was doable.
But that first little bit of shimmy, how he got you past Jazz, that really was a work of art.
Well, actually, 2 scoops helped me with those. So I thank him for that. I'm happy.
Well done. 5 points!
She said she was assisted by Wesley Two Scoops Berry, and there is the man himself. If you saw last week, you know he's in the semifinals.
After one event in the women's competition, Lena Girasimova of Russia, 0. Kim Tyler of the USA, 5. To the men's gauntlet we go. First up for the contenders from Finland, Jarmo Jousisto. And where's the beef, you ask? Why, you need look no further than inside the gauntlet. There's Dynamite, Terminator, the Mighty Warrior, Spartak, and the explosive Nitro. Over to our international referee, John Anderson.
At 5 foot 9 and 11 stone, one of those guys will be twice the size of him, so 5 is going to spell trouble.
Ready!
Well, that's one of the reasons Jarmo came here, to test himself.
Ready!
I love this character, Dynamite. He's just so wide. How do you get past him?
1.
Let's see if Jarmo has the answer.
Good job, Terminator.
He's by two gladiators now.
Oh, look at him.
Trying to tackle Warrior. Not sure that's a good idea.
Short worker Spartak, he meets Nitro now.
Under 10 seconds.
And Nitro determined not to let him through. This can't be on this. Surely.
Gladiators again are not allowed to lean on the contenders. They have to use the apparatus. And I think our referees spotted that. Nitro leaning on Jarmo. Jarmo will get 5 points.
You got through in the end. Tell me, what goes through your mind when you're getting ready to start the event?
I think I must go on. I'm so small guy and these guys are so big, but I think I'm so fast they can't get me. But I'm now really happy because I get 5 points.
28 seconds, 5 points! Well done, Jarmo! Entering the jungle from Finland!
Nitro, a stubborn hombre there, loses his ramrod and still won't let him through. Jarmo rewards him with a leg in the face. Ow!
Now it's Phil Norman's chance to see what he can do against our Gladiators 5-2, referee John Anderson.
6'1", 12 stone, martial arts expert, and of course 1993 British champion, looking for a Norman conquest here.
Substantial number of Phil Norman fans on hand. Norman hoping to use some of that martial arts experience here in the gauntlet.
Oh, Dynamite has been defused there. Oh, look at that.
Terminator has been terminated. Warrior nearly knocks Norman out of the gauntlet.
And Spartak's in the wrong box there. Little previous there. And Phil Norman loses his helmet, but he makes the time.
Under 20 seconds, he gets 10 points.
Phil, congratulations. That was incredible. That was 15-5, 10 points. Phil, I don't think I've seen anybody so psyched up. How do you do it? Is it martial arts?
Yeah, that's what's helping me. Obviously, the game of Gauntlet is going to be very physical. And last week, I've been got battered by women all last week. So I'm just ready to come in and get done again. So.
Magnificent performance. Let's hear it for Phil Norman from Great Britain.
After one event in the men's competition, Jarmo Jousisto of Finland 5. Phil Norman of Great Britain, 10.
Event two, pursuits. Kim from the USA and Lena from Russia, and they're going to be chased by Zodiac and Jazz. Over to John Anderson.
Russia and America, you will go on my first whistle. Gladiators, you will go on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
Zodiac will follow Kim, and Jazz is on Lena's case.
The two contenders, according to the rules, given a 3-second head start. They are both negotiating the snake beam.
A few corners cut there, I think, Mike. Wire bridge.
Kim looking strong, looking solid. Now across the hand ladder. Zodiac trying to close in on Kim Tyler. Getting mighty close, I might add. For a moment, anyway.
Kim already on the low wall.
Lena going through the web trap now. Goes over the low wall.
Oh, stumbles.
Here comes Jazz. Look out, Lena. Down she goes. She'll have to face the music now.
And that leaves Kim with a clear run for the finish. And a little flick-flack there. She does it in style.
10 more points for the USA's Kim Tyler.
Claudette, Kimberly's mother, looking relieved as her daughter stretches her lead in the women's competition.
After two events in the women's competition, Lena Girasimova of Russia, 0. Kim Tyler of the USA, 15.
On to the men's event. Phil from Great Britain and Jarmo from Finland will be chased by Nitro and Wolf. Over to our international referee, John Anderson.
Finland and Great Britain, you will go on my first whistle. Gladiators, you will go on my second whistle.
Nitro 3 seconds to get a head start of Nitro on Phil, and Wolf is after Jarmo.
Wolf and Nitro, a pair of larcenist gladiators. Jarmo and Phil looking mighty strong. They're on the wire bridge right now.
I'm glad you said that, Mike.
Now the hand ladder. They're almost side by side. Phil with the slight lead.
Little bump there as he approaches the quicksand.
Phil the first over the low wall.
Oh, Jarmo's gone down. He's fallen in the quicksand.
And here comes Wolf.
He'll make the most out of that. I don't know if you met Wolf, the oldest of our gladiators.
Still got some bite, huh?
Well, a little long in the tooth, actually.
Phil Norman picks up 10 points.
Well, John, could you please tell us what's happened?
Yes, the rules of this game are clear. Both the contenders and the gladiators must conform to the correct circuit of the course. It will come as no surprise that one of the gladiators failed to complete the proper course, took shortcuts, and as a result gained an unfair advantage. The Finn gains 5 points, and the Wolf is disqualified.
Well, Jarmo, how do you feel about that? The Wolfman has been disqualified. You've been awarded 5 points.
I think that's okay. He's a little bit maniac guy, and maybe too old guy for this kind of games.
Okay, let's hear it for Jarmo from Finland. Points! Phil, you must be very pleased with yourself. Fantastic performance.
I'm just taking one game at a time and just keeping it like that. One game at a time and work my way through.
Well, well done, Phil. 10 points! Let's hear it for Phil Norman from Great Britain.
Why was I disqualified? What's the problem?
John is on his way.
Well, as you well know, you ran when others went on the beam. They went the full course, you didn't. And then you took shortcuts, you didn't stay on the rope wire. In fact, you hardly did any of the course.
Oh, good sportsmanship from the Wolf. Hats off to the referee. Look at this. Wolf didn't even put 1 foot right. Well, Wolf's disqualified. Jarmo gets 5 points. Good decision from the ref.
After two events in the men's competition, Jarmo Jousisto of Finland, 10. Phil Norman of Great Britain, 20.
Well, that's the end of part one. But don't go away, because we'll be back very shortly when you can see some more exciting action here on the International Gladiators!
Welcome back to the National Indoor Arena in Birmingham, England. We are set now for event number three. Don't stop till you get to the top. Our King of the Hill game, it's the pyramid. The women will start things off, and our two contenders are poised at the base of the pyramid. Let's meet them right now. First, from Russia, in the pink uniform, Lena Girasimova. Her opponent from the United States, Kimberly Tyler. Their mission, make it to the top of this 32-foot-high pyramid, where waiting for them are Falcon and Jazz. Over to our international referee, Larry Thompson.
Russia and America, are you ready?
Contenders have 60 seconds to make it to the top of this pyramid.
This is a fabulous event, and I do enjoy it, particularly when they take a tumble. There's Jazz on Lena! And Jazz takes Lena down the Russian steps.
She'll have to start all over again. Meanwhile, Falcon has swooped in on Kim Tyler, has her locked up.
Nice little Jazz steps from Jazz. Did you notice that?
That's right. Duly noted, we're under 30 seconds, and down goes Lena again.
And she must be pulling her leg. This is so easy for Jazz. I don't think anyone's going to get to the top today. Looks like they run out of steam there.
10 seconds remain. Lena back to the bottom, another. time.
It's a bit like snakes and ladders, really. That was the big one. Look at the size of these steps. The girl's absolutely exhausted, Mike.
Each step nearly 2 feet high.
Just like jumping 4 domestic steps at home. I think when Lena goes to bed tonight, she'll be having nightmares, and each nightmare will have jazz in it.
After 3 events in the women's competition, Lena Girasimova of Russia, 0. Kim Tyler of the United States, 15. Our male contenders are ready for the climb of their life in the red uniform from Finland, Jarmo Jousisto. And he'll be going against in the blue uniform, Phil Norman. And high atop the pyramid, waiting for our two contenders, our international gladiators, the Wolfman. Terminator. Over to our international referee, Larry Thompson.
Finland and Great Britain, are you ready? Gladiator, are you ready? 3, 2, 1.
Well, so far, Phil's on maximum points after 2 events. Oh, Terminator took a terrible dive there, and it's 3 for 3 for Phil. Look at those fireworks.
Phil caught Terminator standing still. Now the Wolfman has Jarmo all alone on this pyramid.
And Yarmo's the man who said he was a maniac and too old for the job, if I recall, Mike.
Or Wolf heard those comments.
I think he did. Who's pulling who down here? Now, Wolf normally lies down on the job. He's looking for a place to perch.
Well, he's perched himself right on Yarmo's back. Down he goes, back to the bottom.
Yarmo's helmet falling off there.
15 seconds remain.
And the Wolfman making him eat his words. He's run out of ideas here, Mike.
And just about ready to run out of time.
And there he is. The Wolf is lying down on the job. What did I tell you? Cheek of old Nick.
So far, the day has belonged to Phil Norman. 3 events, a perfect 30 points.
And look at this. The Wolfman steams in on Jarmo just to make him eat his words, because at 42, it's all about age being a state of mind.
Jarmo Jousisto, this was your first attempt at this type of event because you don't have it in Finland. How tough was it for you?
It was too tough, and I was a little bit sad because I get that Mr. Wolf, he's so tough guy. Okay, I do my best, but I didn't be enough good.
In this particular case, it wasn't good enough what your effort was. Phil, you didn't have this event when you won the British Championship in 1993. You put a move on Terminator there that nobody saw. How did you do it? Describe it to us.
Yeah, I just went up. I was looking at the steps, and then I had this feeling that he was really close. I just looked up and I saw him jump, so I went left.
I get the feeling that you are extremely focused for this, not just the pyramid, but this whole competition.
I'm trying to be. It's my martial arts training. It helps you to stay focused to the job at hand.
Paid off here for 10 points. Congratulations, Phil Norman of Great Britain. Yes. After 3 events in the men's competition, Jarmo Jousisto of Finland, 10. Phil Norman of Great Britain, 30.
Event number 4, Powerball. Lena will be using the red balls, and Kim from the USA, the blue balls. And guarding those 5 baskets is Ice, Flash, and Falcon.
Ice from American Gladiators, Flash from Finland, and Falcon, of course, British.
Over to our international referee, Larry Thompson.
Russia!
We're certainly ready for this.
Gladiator, are you ready?
The nervous moments before the whistle blows. Powerball, perhaps
3,
our most physical event.
2,
let's play ball.
1.
Lena needs the points. Ah, good tackle there.
Again, the key for the Gladiators, teamwork. They have to work in concert with one another. Kim Tyler scores, so does Lena. She's finally on the scoreboard.
And bonds it up with another 2 points there.
That time getting by Flash.
And look at Kim. Sells a dummy. Pass two, pass three. Puts it in. It's all too easy.
30 seconds remain now. Poole break the deadlock. Kim Tyler looking for room to run. Falcon won't give it to her. She tries the jump shot. That didn't work.
I think you'd try anything out here, Mike. One of the hardest events. Kim goes for the sprint. 2 points. Yes.
Tried to lull the Gladiator. In that case, Flash to sleep and did.
The pace is slowed down. It's like a walk in the park out there. Oh, she cut away. 2 points. She bisects them.
I can't believe the Gladiators fell for it twice.
Yes.
Kimberly wins at 8-4.
Lena puts her first points on the scoreboard, and look at these Gladiators. When you snooze, you lose.
Well, congratulations, Lena and Kim. Lena, how tough was that?
In the beginning, it was easy. Then the Gladiators improved. It was harder to trick them.
Well, congratulations. You got yourself 4 points. Lena from Russia. Kim, how did you find that? Was it as tough as it looked?
Oh, very much so. It's one of those logic thinking games. You have to actually be thinking about the moves and maneuvers you want to do before you do them. If not, you're dead.
Well, well done. You got yourself 8 points. Kim from the USA.
After 4 events in the women's competition, Lena Girasimova of Russia, 4. Kim Tyler of the USA, 23.
On to the men's event. Jarmo from Finland will be using the red balls, and Phil from Great Britain, the blue. And guarding those 5 baskets is Hawk, Dynamite, and the Mighty Warrior!
Hawk from USA, Dynamite from Russia, and Warrior, our very own British Bulldog.
Over to Larry Thompson.
Finland, are you ready? Great Britain, are you ready? Gladiators, ready!
Phil, with 30 points, has been perfect so far through 3 events.
As you say, Phil focused. Oh, he's dropped the ball straight away.
That time getting the big double team.
Yeah, Dynamite on top of you. That must be fun.
Jarmo did score, however.
Nice move there. Shimmy and 2 points.
Phil is focused.
Dynamite again, but he gets 2 in.
Jarmo uses his quickness to score past Warrior.
Phil.
Another power move. I can't believe that Phil Norman, giving away about 4 stone, still got by Dynamite, the big Russian.
Yeah, it certainly dampened his fuse.
Phil getting double-teamed again, that time by Hawk and Dynamite.
Oh,
look at that!
What is Warrior doing? Tackling him in the no-tackle zone. It'll be off my Christmas card list.
We're under 10 seconds.
And he does it again! Well, we're going to have a word with the referee about this.
Well, that's it. Time expires. Tough go-round for Jarmo. Phil wins at 6-4. Jarmo victimized by some illegal tackling on the part of Warrior.
Hawk says he loves that game, but by the time he actually got to flying over the nest, you could say he was a bit late.
Well, Larry, before we start, I think you've got an announcement to make.
Yes, John, I do. Warrior, in that last game, was very unsportsmanlike for tackling his opponent while he was in the safe zone out of bounds. And while I cannot award any points for that, I am going to disqualify Warrior from the next Powerball game. He will not play for unsportsmanlike conduct.
Thank you, Larry. Warrior has been disqualified for dangerous tackling. What do you think about that, Jarmo?
I think maybe he must go back to school because he don't understand the rules, that red and white area is not area where he can block me. But okay, that's the game.
You're having a hard time this evening. Before with the Wolfman, and now with Warrior. What do you think?
Okay, I hope I win the Phil that
last game, and let's see what happened.
Well, Jarmo, you got yourself 4 points. Phil, were you happy? Was it a fair game, in your opinion?
Yeah, for the hits that I got, yeah, it's fair enough. No one really took my head off, although they did make a meal of my body.
So they're hard, but they're fair.
Yeah, they were hitting me hard. As far as I can't say what happened to Jarmo. I don't know. It's just a shame that it does happen when the game's going like that, because it was a hard game.
Well, you got yourself 6 points.
Contenders know when they play Powerball that hitting goes with the territory. However, in your case, Warrior, the officials are saying that you hit a little illegally, at least in some cases when the contender was out of bounds. But you look bewildered, like you don't understand that that could have possibly have happened. Your thoughts on that match?
As far as I'm concerned, as soon as anybody steps, puts the little toe onto that white matting, yeah, they're mine, okay?
Yeah.
Now, for me, this doesn't cut, because if these guys want to come and play, I play the game hard. And they're playing for a lot of money, you mustn't forget that, okay? I've not hurt anybody or hit anybody illegally here today. I've hit them hard, okay? That's the way I play it.
You seem to have some thoughts about your teammate, Hart.
I'll tell you what, Mike. This event is not for the foolhardy and the faded heart. And I'll tell you what, when we get out there, just like Warrior said, it's us three. Look at his nose. Does that look easy? No, it ain't easy. Look at his face. Well, that happened beforehand. But I tell you what, when we get out here, we play, we hit, we stick. If he's got his foot here, we're going to hit him anyway. All right?
After four events in the men's competition, Jarmo Jousisto of Finland, 14. Phil Norman of Great Britain, 36. Event number five, one-on-one, contender versus gladiator, the duel. First up for our women is Lena Girasimova of Russia. And the gladiator she has to face off against in this 30-second confrontation is Flash.
Flash from Finland, 5'6" tall.
Over to our international referee, John Anderson.
Weighing in at 11 stone.
And one is tempted to feel sorry for little Lena, but don't let that pretty face fool you. She's mighty tough.
She'll give it some.
Right now, she has struck the defensive posture as it's been all Flash so far. I counted at least 5 unanswered shots to the helmet.
Well, Lena's going to have to start getting offensive, otherwise she could be disqualified for not making any attacks.
In her defense, John, I mean, she's giving away 3-4 stone in body weight. I wouldn't want to stand up there against Flash or any other female gladiator for that matter.
Bravery beyond the call of duty. Reminds me of Tommy Steele's musical Half a Sixpence. Flash, bang, wallop, and it's all over. All the heavy artillery coming from Flash.
Well done, Lena. How did it feel being hit like that? You took a lot of punishment up there.
It was very hard for me. I wanted to stay up there because this game was very important to me. I wanted to stay up there, and I did it.
Well, well done. You stayed on, and you got yourself 5 valuable points.
A chance now for the American contender to pad her lead. On the platform for the contenders is Kim Tyler. And she also draws the Finnish gladiator, Flash. To referee, John Anderson.
On top!
Referees were quite generous with Lena Girasimova.
I should say so.
Let's see if they look at Kim's performance with a more critical eye.
And Flash already showing plenty of bash.
Kim trying to mount something of a counterattack, but not the fury we're accustomed to seeing in the duel.
I think Flash is a bit spent out from the last duel that she had with Lena.
Kim Tyler content just to survive. We're down to 5 seconds. She's got the draw and 5 points.
Yes, another solid performance from Kimberly.
And after 5 events in the women's competition, Lena Girasimova, a Russian 9, Kim Tyler of the USA, 28. The men are set for hand-to-hand combat. The duel, first up, representing Finland, Jarmo Jousisto. for this duel, he draws American Gladiator Hawk. Over to our international referee, John Anderson.
Hawk stands 6'4" and weighs over 18 stones.
And poor Jarmo, he has been bent, spindled, mutilated, folded by the gladiators today. And that time is on the receiving end of a jump the gun shot by Hawk.
Although Hawk wants to make friends, I wonder what he's saying in Finnish.
And final warning.
Well, Jarmo grimaced and Hawk took a wild swing.
What's he saying?
The whistle.
Okay, he's got it down now. And Hawk, I know you can count to three now. See if you can get it right this time.
Three, two,
may confuse him, he's doing it backwards. Here they go! Oh, the flying fin!
And Hawk's gonna take credit for that.
He'll take all he can get.
Well, Jarmo, you're really having a tough time with Powerball, but I can't see too much wrong with that one.
Yeah, but okay, that's the game in here, Naga.
Well, unfortunately, Jarmo, no points, and they get tougher. Let's hear it for Jarmo!
And the crowd here at National Indoor Arena, wild in their anticipation for the next contender. There he is, from Great Britain, Phil Norman. Over to our referee, John Anderson. Phil, with that martial arts background, he's no stranger to hand-to-hand combat.
And that grimace. This is Duel, not a face-pulling competition.
Uh-oh, Hawk off balance. Down goes Phil. By rule, the gladiator not allowed to cross over to the contender's platform. That results in automatic disqualification. What happened?
To me, Mike, it looked like Hawk lost control of his body weight. Let's check it out. Goes for the lunge. And look at that. Tries to regain his composure. Knocks Phil over in the process.
Here's the ruling.
Well, John, can you tell us exactly what your verdict was on that?
The rules require that you remain on your own platform. And in this case, that did not happen. The result of the contest is a win to the contender.
And no one more happy than Phil's mum.
Once again, Phil, this is your night. Tell us, Phil, what was Hawk actually saying to you while you were up there?
He was growling at me, actually. He was growling.
Did you think you would knock him off? I mean, you fought against some big, tough guys up there. How does he rank amongst them?
You know, I've been hit by the best of the British, and now I've been hit by the best of the American. It's always on the day.
Well done, Phil. You got yourself another 10 points! Phil Norman from Great Britain! Hawk, what actually happened? Did you lose your balance, or was it a blow?
Well, I tell you what, Fash, he's a good kid. He's a big upper. He's kind of thin, but he's a big, strong kid. And I was swinging at him, and I kept hitting him pretty good. He was hitting me, and I started falling forward. So I tried to bounce myself off of him, and in essence, he was a little bit too thin for me. I knocked him over. Get some bigger contenders here, Fash. Come on! Man, we feed the son of a gun!
Feed the Hawk!
Anything you say, Hawk, after five events of the men's competition. Jarmo Jousisto of Finland, 14. Phil Norman of Great Britain, 46.
So, join us after the break for the Eliminator here on the International Gladiators!
To the National Indoor Arena in Birmingham, England. And in just a few moments, two more of our international contenders will move on to the semifinals based on their performance in the Eliminator. Our women will start things off, and right now, Kim Tyler of the USA has a 19-point lead. That will give her a 9.5-second head start over Lena Girasimova of Russia.
America, you leave on my whistle. Russia, you leave on John's whistle. Three, two, one.
9.5 seconds. It's going to seem like 9.5 weeks to Lena, who just has to stand there and watch this girl go.
Yeah, what Lena needs, John, is a minor miracle against an athlete as talented as Kim Tyler. It's happened before, but not often.
The main thing is about contenders on Gladiators, as you rightly know, is they never give up till the end.
Kim making short work of that hand ladder.
I've never seen anything like that. What a technique.
She breezes across the rolling beam, working her way up the cargo net. Lena hoping that Kim makes some kind of mistake.
And now she joins her on the cargo nets. I would say she's made up some of that lead, wouldn't you, Mike?
And Lena's fans sense that she is capable of a comeback here now.
Definitely narrowed the gap.
Down the zip line, this is the only breather our contenders get on this eliminator course.
I don't know what she's saying, but it's in Russian. But yeah, sure, it's
gonna
move on.
Lena, yeah. Please, Lena, you can do it, Lena.
Here she comes. Good landing.
Kim successfully negotiates the balance beam. Now the travelator. She has done it. Kim Tyler from California and the USA moving on to the semifinals.
Meanwhile, Lena from Moscow attacks. Oh, she slipped on the travelator. And the fans so disappointed. They're winning her off. John Anderson telling her to keep her head up. That's important, isn't it, Mike?
It is, John. Lead with your chin. You win. Head down. You wear a crown.
She finally conquers the awesome eliminator. Lena Girasimova from Russia with love.
Well, Kim, congratulations. Another winner on the International Gladiators. How does it feel?
Well, it feels great. This is a big arena. Thanks for all my support. My mom, my dad couldn't be here. I know he's watching at home. Hi, Dad. Love you. And I'd like to say that Elena's a very good competitor. I think in a way I had a little bit of advantage because they don't have these games in Russia. So I kind of knew what to expect a little bit. So she is a great athlete. Thank you.
Congratulations. Let's hear it for Kim, all the way from the USA.
Lena Girasimova, she's been here all day long. She's given it her best shot. Put it in perspective for us. How did it go? Did you have a good time? What was it like?
It was very hard, but I tried to do my best to finish the course. I tripped on the travelator, but I managed to finish it. It's a beautiful game. I like it very much. I want to do it again in the future. Magnificent.
Lena, in any language, your performance was worthy of a big ovation. Let's hear it for Lena Girasimova of Russia.
So, before the men's event, let's have a timeout.
I would like to say to all my fans that if they want to be gladiators, there are three things you got to remember. Eat properly, good food, train hard, and go to sleep early in the night time.
Be yourself, be an individual, and remember who you are and where you came from at all times.
Try to look at the positive things in life. Anything that you engulf yourself in, try to find the good. It's always easy to find the bad, but try to find the good in it.
The heart is bigger than the man. So if you don't have the physical capabilities, if you have a strong heart, a strong desire, compassion, discipline, you can overcome anything and be everything that you want to be. Don't be afraid to live your dreams.
The moment of truth is at hand here in the men's eliminator, and Phil Norman of Great Britain will take a 32-point lead going into the eliminator over Jarmo Jousisto of Finland. That is worth a 16-second head start. Over to our international referee, John Anderson.
Great Britain, you will go on my whistle. Finland, you will go on Larry's whistle. 3, 2, 1.
You know, it's not that Jarmo Jousisto has been that bad. It's been that Phil Norman has been that good. He's in the zone today. Can't do anything wrong.
Absolutely, Mike. And the question is, will he get to start before Phil gets to the end?
Here he goes. Jarmo be there. Up and over.
I didn't know you could sing, Mike.
I can. Isn't that evident?
It certainly is. Phil Norman seems like a mile away, and look at that guy struggle on the rope. Jarmo having a tough time today.
Phil Norman has reached the zip line. Jarmo working his way across on a hand bike.
Oh, man! Look at that. I've never seen that before.
That was about a 30-foot fall. Is he okay? Yes.
He's up and running. And he's still got the composure on the balance beam. His heart must be pumping. Phil Norman pops up the travelator. This man is tireless. He's in the semifinals.
And there was never any real question. He was in it to win it from the very beginning. Flawless performance.
Well, the only thing I can say about Jarmo is he's made a few friends. There's Wolf, there's Hawk, there's Warrior. It's been a long day, and you can see it in this guy's face.
And once again, the crowd here in the National Indoor Arena aren't about to let this guy call it quits. And finally, the Finn is finished. But not before earning a whole lot of admirers.
Congratulations, Phil. That was incredible. I don't think we've ever seen anybody fall off a zip line. But especially that height. Are you okay?
Yeah, I just lost my grip, just going too fast. Grabbed hold of it and then I lost it. One hand slipped and it was gone. I couldn't hold it with one hand.
Well, well done, Phil. A lot of people have been supporting you. I think you want to thank some of them.
Yeah.
It's deafening in here, absolutely deafening.
Apart from the people of Great Britain anyway, my students have followed me up, my family, the guys in the front door. Thanks for coming up.
Now, I know you want to borrow my mic, but congratulations, Phil. Another winner on the International Gladiators. Take it away.
Thank you. Last year, after winning the Gladiators, there was one more achievement that I wanted to do, and that was to propose to my girlfriend, Lynn. So, in front of everybody here and everybody watching at home, Lynn, will you marry me?
Yes!
Well, Mike, I don't know what takes more courage, facing the Gladiators or proposing to a girlfriend in front of 8,000 people.
Imagine if she'd have said no. And from the ecstasy of a marriage proposal to the agony of defeat, I want you to take a look at the body of Jarmo Jousisto of Finland. People who watch this on television say, hey, it's not real. These guys don't put any effort out. He's got a scraped up knee, a sprained wrist, blood on his hands. Let this man know how much you care. Jarmo, I know you feel pretty rotten. You should have won this thing in your mind, but you have nothing to be ashamed about. Your thoughts on the whole day, the whole competition.
Sad, but I like to say all people in this audience, it was be so nice to be here and nice guy this Phil. I hope to him when he go to semifinals that he win also that semifinals. He's so nice guy and a really good sport guy.
Well, you're a good sport as well. I know this is probably a rotten question at this moment. Would you like to do this again?
Of course, why not?
Why not indeed? Jarmo Jousisto of Finland. So two more contenders qualify for our semifinals. Phil Norman from Great Britain and Kim Tyler from the USA. For John Fashanu and all of us here at the National Indoor Arena, I'm Mike Adamley. See you again on International Gladiators.
For safety reasons, do not attempt to recreate any of the events you have seen on Gladiators.
The Eliminator has been reset and is ready and waiting. Let's hope those thighs are up for the Travelator. Join Ulrika and Fash again for more Gladiators next on Challenge. Whilst over on Pick, let's hope there's nothing to declare.
Music with more muscle.